The passion's there. The kids play with their hearts. But we're losing. But anyway, it's going to get a lot better.
It's too early to decide, but the first game, we played a really good team, three of us, and we pulled it off.
We've got a good crowd out here. The boys are excited, and we already scored a touchdown against USA. So.
Honestly, I think this season is going to be different than
any
other.
We're going to have a great
season. I think that we're actually gonna do great this
season.
It's
going to be great.
We have a good senior this year, and I hope we are going 10-0.
Us to be undefeated and go maybe at least three rounds deep into the playoffs.
Get your money on that?
Yeah, I would.
Yeah, same as her. I expect them to go very far and to go very well.
We'll follow up to 39.
Let's go, baby. Let's go.
Four, Perry, right up the middle once again. Hit hard. Well, there, keep her up the middle. Flags out to the left. 45, Bailey Gaddis. Oh, man, running hard.
Thank you.
just got to say that we got to work harder every week to get better and to improve our talent that we have. We have a lot of talent, and I feel like we can go far this year, but we just got to work.
How about you, Mikey?
I mean, I believe we did good in the first half. We just got to keep building our momentum. Can't let us have dumb penalties like we did tonight. I mean, we just got to keep working hard and do all the things we were taught. Games should be ours all the time.
And what do you have to say about this next game that's
coming up? We're hungry. We're going to come back a lot harder, a lot more physical. We're going to put some points on the board.
We just had too many missed assignments. We know what we need to work on, and we're going to get it done this week.
Well, man, it was, you know, we just beat ourselves. We're better.
We should have won, bro. We should have won.
Yeah. We're a better team. We're a better team than them.
Defense needs to step it up.
No. We just beat ourselves, man. We drove down the field the first quarter, and, we just kind of laid back. And which you shouldn't do that. You know, in football, you have to go 100 miles per hour. And we didn't. We laid back and we let them beat us. It was all on us. But we're a better team. Definitely a better team.
What do you think you bring in for the next game?
We're just going to have to bust our butts in practice. And, let's see what happens,
Our boys excel in everything. We have nothing but great kids here in Bishop. All our kids will excel in any sport they try to do. They work hard every day in the weight room and outside in the running. Overall, our girls are just as good. I mean, our program, I think, is going to excel throughout every sport.
Oh, it's the heart of the school. Everybody likes football. Everybody likes Friday nights under the lights. And the Badgers are great. It's a good way for the community to come together.
I feel Bishop football is so special because it has it's traditional, and there's a lot of teamwork involved in it.
I feel like it brings the team together and the town. It brings the town together, and it just brings everyone, like, as a family, closer together, honestly.
Now I believe after we've got the hardest one is always the first one. So once we got that first one, not only is our team starting to believe, I think our coaching staff, our community, you know, the school itself is starting to believe, starting to back up the players. So it makes it a lot easier once you've experienced it before. Now you know you can do it, and it makes it a lot easier to compete. And then when you have the backing and the support of the schools, the community, the parents, the coaches, etc., it makes winning a lot easier.
Football's different because football brings the community together. When you have the band, when you have the pep squad, when you have the football players, you have the team captains, and you bring all this excitement together, it involves more, and the community gets involved. And what you can tell right now is that we're very excited about what's going to be coming.
When the community is up and spirited and trying to support us, you know, it definitely helps us, honestly. You know, you may not see it, but it really does get our spirits going and carries on to practice, to games. You know, we're excited, you know, to get that win for the community.
There's nothing like Friday night with the band and the football team and the whole school and community coming together to play a great game of football.
I think there's a lot of great support. I really appreciate it. Like, even though we'd have losses, I mean, there'd be people that leave, but a good chunk of people would still stay to, you know, tell us good game and stuff after the game. And I really appreciated that, especially being out there and to have a loss. It just really hits you. And sometimes that's just what you need, is someone telling you that you did good. And sometimes it just happens.
The boys come together more as a team and as brothers than any other sports.
I agree. They do come together as a team, and it's something they look forward to very much, and it's something that everyone can participate in, no matter how big, how small.
It's the excitement of bringing a new season, a new team, a new tradition, and hopefully bring the whole community together to support the Bishop Badgers and our band and the cheerleader and all the activities that take place when you have a good football season.
I think we're really excited about this season because we haven't won a game in quite a while, but we've got like some new energy, new coaches, and the boys are really pumped, and I think it's gonna be a really great season.
Tell you the truth, I don't think our boys lack much. Our boys are, like I said, they're very good, they're very motivated. I think what we lack is the numbers.
The downfall we have right now is numbers. We don't have a lot of players compared to other schools.
You know, we don't have that many kids coming out, you know, but other than that, I mean, the kids that come out, they give it all they got.
They're small. I mean, I'm an outside linebacker, and kids my size should be around 200-something pounds, and I'm only, like, 180.
So we play the bigger schools. You know, we average probably between 25 to 30 kids on the team. we're playing teams that have more players. Well, our players got to go both ways, so they get tired quickly. The other teams can rest and spot play them. So I think conditioning and fatigue would come through, because on watching film, Bishop was in a lot of close games, just couldn't win them at the end. So I think that conditioning was a factor.
Well, one thing for sure, we got a new offense, and that helps out a lot too. We got some new coaches, you know, and a little different philosophy and stuff. Last year, all our games were in 5 games or 6 games within 2 points or 3 points. We're in every game. That's what was the whole thing that kind of be like, man, you know, but still, a loss is a loss and a win is a win. So this year, I think with that new offense and the way where our kids are, I think it's going to work out great for our team.
We have had a little bit of a crisis for many years now, and we have been in a position where we have not had winning seasons, and it's a special group for us because we want the wins super bad. So that's why it's special, and we're really excited about this season. So it's going to be fantastic, and I think things are going to be changing quite a bit.
Big picture, life skills. Number one, if you apply for any job or any kind of career, nowadays you're going to be part of a team.
We are the ones that have heart, dedication, anything. Like, I've never seen this team ever before in my life. They work hard. I've seen them during off season or 2 days, and they were busting their butts off, wanting to be in it. I even saw an underclassman here every summer working off and doing stuff just to get on varsity, just to get ready for this season.
Yeah, I agree.
Time management is built in through football. Of course, mental toughness, and in our lives, you're going to have ups and downs. It's part of life. And I think through football, it'll teach our players when things go tough, you know, you bow your neck and you stand up and you get after it instead of folding. And then along with that comes the discipline and the hard work and the structure. And hopefully, you know, we all want to win games, but as coaches, hopefully we're preparing them for the future. And the skills are going to need it to be successful. I think that's football builds it.
It's too early to decide, but the first game we played a really good team, 3 overs, and we pulled it off. Right now we had a rough start, but I think we're going to come back. We're going to regain our composure, and we're going to win. We're going to have a winning season.
And how do you expect district to go?
It's going to be tough. There's a lot of good teams. San Diego's won the district, I don't know, I believe 5 years in a row, something like that. Aransas Pass is always good, and they have a lot of kids, but they're a real big school. Those two teams are probably the favorites just on their history and their tradition. Falfurrias and the two Valley schools, Santa Rosa and Lyford, have made the playoffs before, so they know how to win. Obviously, we're always picked last. I understand that. That's not a problem. The good thing is games are decided on the field, not on magazines and newspapers, so we're fine. But top four teams get in. Our goal is to get into the playoffs. That's step one. If we can, we want to win the district championship.
Thank you.
We're going to win, bro. Yeah. We're going to make playoffs. We're going to make history.
Yeah.
Thank you for coming out. We also have the Bishop Badger Pro Shop open. Lucha Clubs. Come visit.
Family on three, one, two, three.
Family! Here we come.
from your bedroom.
Once again, that's Harvard against the Greyhound. The loss of about six. Mahoney was a little bit downfield. They'll bring up second and 18. To give it to Vasquez, he's on the right side. Nice tackle. Try number. Well, that's your rolling right. Need a little help, trying to get a little goal line stand.
Midfield to determine who gets the ball first.
Family on three. One, two, three, family.
Goes to rolling right, throwing right. Pass is caught. That's number one. They both brought their A game. I think we need to give these boys a big round of applause.
Twice in the third quarter. Who beat us tonight? Who beat us? Big time, we're gonna move on. Right? We're growing, we're growing. You did what I asked you to take your ass off. That's what I want. Okay, I know it sucks to lose, but I'm proud.
A hard loss. I've been playing with a lot of these boys for a long time, including the seniors now. I've played with some of them since I started freshman year. And it really sucks to have lost this game, but I mean, I would have wished we had won, but I would have had it no other way. No other team, because I love these guys out here, and they play their hearts out. That's all
it was a tough loss, honestly, but this team right here, it's a playoff team. And you know, even though we lost, I think we made progress. We played our butts off, played with our hearts, and that's all that matters. Coach Rio says that, you know, it's just we're building up, but when district comes, we'll be there.
It was a hard loss, but I think it's a stepping stone that nobody expected for us to come this far. Having that they beat West Oso, it means a lot, because that means we should have won and everybody knew that this isn't the same team from last year. It's come so far. The connection is greater than the past 5 years. The connection, everybody loves everybody. It's not I, it's team.
You call it a family.
Yes. And every time we break it out in the huddle, everywhere, it's family. Family on three. It's not win. It's family. It's family, the most important part, because that's why we almost had them. They were breaking apart. We stuck together. I mean, they had a lucky play.
It sucks, we lost, but I think in the most part we learned a lot from our loss today, and how penalties can kill a team, how all the turnovers can kill a team. And I think at the end of the day we learned a lot more than from losing than we did winning the game, like if we would have won the game. So we're going to get ready for next week and we'll get that W.
The loss, nothing good about that last part. We should have won the game. We played the playoff team. I know these guys since freshman year in eighth grade. I know how they play, but we're supposed to execute like we're supposed to. We should have lost this game.
Bishop CISD 2015. This is my first year. I knew the wins were, there weren't very many wins, but I knew I knew we could turn the program around, and we're doing okay this year. We're 2-3 right now. Could be 3-2. We let one slip away in overtime, but and for the future, we got good kids. We're gonna have several starters back next year, so I think we can build Bishop into one of the better programs in South Texas.
Okay, my name is George Loon, the athletic director here at Bishop CISD. The whole thing is what my coach is embracing me when I was going through high school and college. You know, there's, what you put into it is what you get out of it. When you work hard, good things happen.
So when that's Coach Loon called and asked me about the Bishop job, it was a no-brainer. I accepted it. And I know they were struggling. Understand what we got here, myself and some other coaches. Basically, the first time we met the kids was the first day of tour days, which was early August. You know, you're learning names, you're learning faces. They played different positions in the past, so I'm trying to learn their names, what they can do, their strengths, their weaknesses, how do they fit into our system. And to their credit, they're very teachable, they're very coachable, they're very respectful, they're hard workers, they're good learners. So it made it kind of easy, I guess as easy as it could be. Now we're about 2 months later. I can see them building as a team now. Now we have a team concept going. We're playing for each other. They're understanding the concept and the strategies that we're trying to teach them. And we won a couple of games and almost could have won some other games that I think they believe now that they're a good team and we can play with them.
It was weird. I always liked Coach Una. He's one of my favorite coaches. I love the intensity from him. I think he knew what he was doing. I would respect any decision he made, whether it was a step down, whether it was to stay. I believe he'd made the right choice. And any choice he makes is usually the right choice, because he's not one to just care for himself. He cares about us. And even though he stepped down, I mean, he was still there on the sidelines, going to the practices, still helping, and it just showed how much he cared, that he was willing to give his spot for someone that could help make a change, and even then he still came and supported us.
It was rough, I ain't gonna lie. I like to be on the sidelines. I like to yell. I'm real intense. This year I was more of just throw them back a little, you know, and seeing how everything worked out and stuff. But for the most part, it's good. I like it because I oversee a lot more things now, and it's gonna help out the whole program. But stepping down, yeah, it's painful to be there, but at the same time, it's sweet because now I'm getting more to the kids that they need.
Honestly, I really don't think it was the coaching staff's problem. You know, he did everything for us. You know, he gave us what we needed, you know, the plays that we needed to cover on, you know, everything. And it really just, we didn't live up to what we needed to do and get the job done, you know. I mean, don't get me wrong, you know, he's a great coach and everything, but him stepping down, you know, it gives us a new refresh, like a new start over, you know, and I think it's the right choice.
It was tough, you know, these new coaches came in and
and the seniors being there. You know, we were still used to our old ways, you know. We got too used to
physically losing. Coach Luna and everybody that's been here has done a great job. The kids are tough and they play hard. I challenge them a little bit more mentally. Just for example, our playbook alone, I mean, we probably have 50 to 60 plays that you have to know what to do on the fly. You know, we rep it so much that usually it becomes an instinct, but physically, of course, as coaches, we'll get you bigger, faster, stronger. We'll run you and condition you. We'll get you in the weight room. But if you don't have the mental part, the fight when things are tough, when you don't feel like working out that day, your body's telling you you're tired and you got to push yourself.
Fight to the finish, honestly. You know, you hear everyone saying that, but it don't matter about the scoreboard. Honestly, you just got to finish where you started, you know. Yeah, we may be losing, you know, like 20-0. You know what? We can still make a comeback. You know, we got to fight to the finish and make sure we finish strong no matter what the score is. Because in the end, when you come out strong and finish strong, no matter what the score is, you're going to have a great next week of practice.
Go out there, we usually have the mentality that we're going to win. Not usually, but we always have the mentality that we're going to win. It's just once the other team gains the lead, that mentality is gone. And there's a few of us that keep it, and we try to keep it instilled. But it just tends to fade away, and once that happens, the score gap gets bigger and bigger, and just you lose that mentality, and then it's gone.
Two parts, the mental part, and of course the physical part. I think it starts with mental toughness, what I mean by that is the grind. I call it the grind, the hard work that it takes to be successful. Meaning, you know, coming to practice every day after school and sacrificing time to be with your friends. Giving up time during the summer to come to summer workouts to build up your body for a long season. The grind of getting home late when you're tired and having to study for your classes. Basically giving up a lot of free time to do what it takes to win and to do things right, okay? Physically, of course, as coaches, we'll get you bigger, faster, stronger. We'll run you and condition you. We'll get you in the weight room. But if you don't have the mental part, the fight when things are tough, when you don't feel like working out that day, your body's telling you you're tired and you got to push yourself. If you don't have the mental part of that part, it's hard to win. And that's what separates teams that win every year versus teams that barely win.
Christian Castillo, number two, Eli Saldana, barely able to wrestle him down.
I think our fault is we see as soon as they score one touchdown over us, no matter the score, 0-7, 7-14, our mentality just goes to, we've lost this game. We've been losing for so long that as soon as the score changes and we're at the disadvantage, the kids automatically assume that the game's over and nobody wants to try.
Better trained, they're faster, they're stronger, there's exercise science, there's sports medicine. Our athletes are different. They're different, they're playing at a different level, they can take harder hits, they can give harder hits, and they're a lot faster.
It's growing the school.
school's grown. Definitely grown. Gotten a lot bigger than when I was in school.
It hasn't changed that much.
It hasn't changed?
I don't know. I was on the field, so I don't remember.
I have to say that back when I was in school in 1993, I can say the spirit was just a little bit more deep. But I do have to say that this year, 2015, I think we've awoken the Badger. It's a beautiful thing to see that my son is a senior this year, and it runs through the blood, green and gold.
Came and we lost the second game, and that was tough, but we came back and, you know, had a rocky three games after our first win, and but the fans still kept coming. We had a lot of sold out games, like sold out home games.
You know, and these kids, you know, they respect that. You know, they have that in their blood. You know, they're like, man, it's been in their genes, inherited from their parents. All of them are from here, from Bishop.
I'm the first grandchild and son or kid like in my parents' generation with their parents, and I've always just been an avid football player. So for my family, it's just been football all the time ever since I was little, and they love coming and watching me play football. They love inviting their friends to play football, and just football has always mattered a lot to my family, and I see that in everybody else's, a lot of my friends' family too. We're all just football families that love watching pro, college, anything, but really coming and watching us on Friday nights is one of their favorite things of life.
Brother, he played high school football back in probably around 07 is when his freshman year. He graduated in 2010. I remember probably when I was back in elementary and prime, no, actually in fourth grade. And I used to go on Friday nights, you know, watch him play. I used to love watching him play, actually, you know, with my friend Alan. His brother was in football too, and we would go watch our brothers play. Everyone would say he would smell, but I just like hugging him after the games, you know, because he was my big brother, so I looked up to him.
I know that feeling. I mean, I remember coming out when I was in fourth grade, coming to Friday night football games. We'd be playing football on the side, be watching those boys, and you know, I can't wait till I get play on those Friday night lights, and it's just one of the coolest things to watch those guys play. And you know, now I'm here, and I look on the sideline every now and then, and over there in the space where they play, and I'm like, that was me. And I can see, like, I know those kids are looking up to us. I know those little football players, like, they see us and they want to be us, and it makes me feel good. So that's why I try to set a good example. I don't trash talk, don't play dirty. Try to give them a good example, something to follow that's good.
It's a great community, honestly, you know. They live up to their expectations, now we've got to live up to ours. You know, we've got to win some games for their community, you know, get the spirit going.
I think it's pretty important. I mean, it's kind of living in the shadow of baseball, especially since football hasn't been doing so well. Baseball is basically ruining it right now, but I still think it's pretty important, especially how our first game we'd sold out the whole stadium, and that's never been done.
You hear it a lot about how football really brings us together as a family, you know. You hear us talk about it a lot. And you may see it, kind of a little bit, but it really does carry on in school too, you know. I mean, you may not know a lot of people, but after coming out of football and varsity, or JV too, you know, it really brings us close together, you know. It lets you know that person is always going to have your back, no matter what the circumstances is. You're going to, like, you feel comfortable around. You feel like they're your brothers. Your brothers in arms, you know. You want to fight for them. You want them to fight for you. And it really feels like one big happy family.
I especially believe next year is going to be a big turnaround. He knows what we're capable of. He knows how we play. So I believe he's going to really model his whole scheme around the way we play and stuff. And that'll definitely help. And I think that next year's going to be a good year. And plenty of the years after that, because once we have one good year, it'll build up. And if we have one good year, the next year's good. People are gonna start wanting to come to Bishop. The people that play football will take it more seriously, and our football program will become bigger and better. And
these young guys, they're lucky because they're gonna have the first off season with these new coaches, and the new coaches are great. You know, they're good coaches.
We changed everything around, actually. The new coaching staff, you know, new attitudes, new everything. I think next year is going to be a really great season. We turned everything around since last season to this season.
It was a bit of both. I had found out, or someone had told me that it was the first time Bishop's ever beaten, when we beat Three Rivers, it was the first time Bishop ever beaten Three Rivers. And I mean, that was probably one of the coolest feelings to know that I was on that squad that did that.
Because, yeah, baseball is always going to be there. And that is, you know, like, we're very good at baseball, and the town really supports the baseball player. But, man, I really feel like deep down inside, you know, these people want to see us. They can't wait till we're up there in football. Because, like, I mean, you should have, like, I mean, if you've seen some of the games, I mean, like, the town would, you know, they would really cheer us on whenever we make a big play. Like, they were into it because we were good. We were talented. And I feel like they're just waiting.
Like I tell everybody, you know, your senior year is when you had nothing but memories. And when it comes down to it, at the end, even when the season is done, that's it. You probably won't ever put on other pads, another helmet, and unless you go play the next level. And then, you know, if you do play next level, it's nothing like growing up with the friends you've grown up with since you were little and playing ball with, you know, with other towns that have been rivals. I mean, that's what you miss, and that's what you play for. You know, you're playing for your community.
Receiver number 24, Miguel Garcia.
There's still a lot of time left.
Wait, say?
Still a lot of time left. We got this.
You got it?
We got 7 to 25.
That deep for the batter, number 22, John Fernandez.
Yes, it is.
Number 12, Michael Herrera.
tumbling down, pledging their love to the ground. Lonely but free I'll be found, drifting along with a tumbling tumbleweed. Cares of the past are behind.
I think that I'm ready, the team's ready, the coaches are ready. We've worked so much, you know, so hard for basically to get to this point, and it would really suck to come up short.
Honestly, we can beat every single team in our district.
A lot of off-season time, I think we're ready to win.
We're going with confidence, ready to win all the time, but never big-headed. We're focused, ready to get on that field, do the best we can, every single play, every single second, just everything we can possibly do to get the win.
I think this is the best team in Bishop. Best team so far.
Keep rolling along. Deep in my heart is a song. Here on the range I belong. Drifting along with a tumble.